It's 7 a.m. in the mountain village of Namuku, announced with typical Japanese eccentricity by the town alarm clock. Seven-year-old Yusuke Aiwa and his brother and sister are off to school. Namuku Elementary School dwarfs the houses around it. There used to be over 1,200 students here. Now there are only 37. Yusuke is in first grade. He's been top of his class all year. But there's a simple reason for that. He's the only pupil. Headmaster Masuda Mitsunobu concedes that Yusuke's isolated lessons aren't without challenges.
悪いところは1対1、1人で丁寧に教えられるから、例えば教えすぎるところ、あとは集団での活動ができない、複数での学習、体育とか、そういうものはやりにくくなると。
It's only at recess and lunch that Yusuke gets to play with his friends. For how much longer is unclear. With the entire population of the town slipping away, the future of the school is hanging in the balance.
What is the reason for that big decrease?
で、一つは南牧について言えば、仕事、職場がないということで、親の世代が南牧以外のところへ 行って住んでしまうと、そうすると子供の数は当然減ってくると。南牧村に子供がいる限りは小学校は南牧に残ります。ただ子供がゼロになった時には小学校がいらなくなりますので、そういう時には休校になります。
Every year, fewer babies are being born and more young people are leaving. Hundreds of homes and businesses are boarded up or abandoned. Left behind are the elderly. More than half of the population is over the age of 65.
少ないっていうことはもう村の 学校ですから、村のことなんだけれども、まあ日本全体のまあごく一部ですね、南牧村。だから南牧村で起きていることがおそらく将来は日本でも起きるだろうというふうには考えてますが。For
almost 40 years, Tomio Ichikawa worked in Namuku's once thriving timber industry.
職はね、だいたい、リフォーム、改造というか、うちをこうちょっと部分的に直す、リフォームって、リフォームわかります？改造とか改修とか、で、そのぐらいの仕事だね、細かい仕事。で、この村の中で、新しいうちなんて作ることはもうなくなっちゃった。自分たちみたいな、小さい一人でやってるような、
If the population keeps diminishing the way it is, are you worried the village is simply going to die out?
定義区がね、まあ、1年100人近くが減るということは、今2000人だとしたらもう20年もしたらいなくなっちゃうという。で、仕事、俺の仕事もやっぱり人がいないと成り立たないから仕事だから、その不安はいっぱいあるということはあるね。
Tomio invites me to meet his family.
Australia.
He only married 4 years ago and says he and his wife are too old to have children of their own. The couple care for Tomio's elderly parents.
そういう給食の仕事してた、学校の子供の、この村だけでもね、今の人口の1400人ぐらい子供がいたん。困っちゃうね、寂しいね、寂しいよ。若い人がいなくなるってことは寂しい。
In bustling Tokyo, there's little sense of the impending crisis. But some experts warn that within a millennium, the Japanese people themselves could be extinct. Why aren't Japanese having more babies?
お金がないから。保障とか制度が弱いのとか、お給料面、お金の面の方が強いのかな。あと子供を産んだら自由な時間が少なくなっちゃうからとか。
心配ですよ。なんかこれからの未来が若い人たちで作れなくなってしまうかな。
Today, more than half of Japanese women are still single by the time they're 30. Karu Arai is a professional harpist.She epitomizes the country's new breed of successful and financially independent women who are putting career first and postponing marriage and motherhood.
Did you always think that marriage and children was a certainty?
Yes, I've always thought that I would be a mom, you know, and I would have a family just like my parents.
Yeah. And now?
And I don't know, all of a sudden I'm 32.And just hasn't happened yet.
She says she worries that her potential husband won't earn as much as she does and won't accept her work schedule that includes evenings and weekends.
But you're picky.
But I'm picky. Yes, I want it all. I've waited this long, I want the right person.
And you want to be a successful harpist?
Yes. Want my cake and eat it too.
In a desperate move to pull the birth rate back from the brink, the Japanese government is offering cash incentives to encourage singles like Karu to partner up and procreate.
Do you ever worry that Japan might not be around in a thousand years?
Not even a thousand years. I think I've read somewhere that we're going down in like 100, you know, we're going to be extinct.
Because no one's having babies.
Exactly, no one's having babies. And...I've heard, I don't know if you've heard the term, but there's this new word in Japan called soshokuke danshi, which means herbivoric men. And the men aren't as hungry for success or for
relationships,
yeah, as they were before.
Japanese men aren't interested in having sex.
Nope. At least that's what I hear.
So it's not justdown to women, it's men have got to do their bit too.
Yeah, definitely. They need to be, you know, more confident. They need to stop shaping their eyebrows. You know, they have to start looking more like men.
Akihiro and Yuka Arima are having a rare night out together.The couple have been married for 2 years, but are hesitant to start a family.
It's not easy for women to, you know, raise children and working at the same time.
Yuka is 27 and works for an electronics company.
I don't want to give up my job. I want to keep working in the same place. But if I come back to my workplace after I took the maternity leave, I may not have the same position, same jobs, so I worry about it.
Yuka also fears that in a culture that encourages excessive work hours, her husband's long days as a warehouse manager will leave her holding the baby.
Japanese men work so much, so hard. So my husband comes back home around 11 p.m. every day.
11 p.m.?
Yes. So if I have a child, I have to, you know, take care of my children by myself. So, but it's not rare.
Do you think that the government needs to do more to address this problem?
We need more government support. Many Japanese don't think it's serious situation.
Do you think it's serious?
Yeah, I think serious. I think serious.
At the Isai Hospital on the outskirts of Tokyo, it's another busy day. This is the flip side of Japan's demographic time bomb, a rapidly aging population and a lack of staff to look after them.
Their elderly is increasing and they need more health workers. Actually, that's their problem today.
Nurse Excelsis John Bourbon came here 3 years ago from the Philippines. Japan has a reluctance to employ foreign health workers, and so he is one of the lucky ones. After 3 years, foreign health workers are required to take an exam in Japanese.
Yes, and I'm very lucky to pass that exam, but I didn't expect to pass that exam because it's really difficult. It's like a gamble. It's like a gamble in your life.
With a failure rate of almost 90%, Excelsis says the exam is designed to make it almost impossible to pass. Such strict barriers to immigration mean some hospitals are so short-staffed they have no option but to close.
やはりそこの病院っていうのは地域の中になくてはならない存在になっておりますので、やはりそこは潰してはいけないと思うんですね。
Miyoko Miyasawa has been a nurse for almost 40 years. She's now an advisor to the Isai Hospital and is a vocal proponent of Japan's need to relax its insular and restrictive immigration laws.
人材確保っていうのはそういう少子化の中でとても大事なことなんですけども、やはりそこの人材確保をどうしていくかっていうことは病院経営者がやっぱりそれを重点的に考えて、そういう対策を取らなければいけないかと思います。必要になってくるかと思います。
Japan's seemingly xenophobic reluctance to admit foreign workers means the country is seeking an answer to its manpower shortage elsewhere.
I can recognize your face, answer your questions, play music.
Major companies are racing to develop the robot of the future, and it's people like Hitomi Suzuki who could benefit.
Hitomi, what do you think of it?
Yeah, that's cute.
Hitomi broke her neck in a car crash 28 years ago. She's now helping Toyota design a robot to assist the elderly and disabled with everyday activities.
介助者がいなくても家で一人で過ごせることが素晴らしいと思います。
Already a range of specialized robots have been developed, from machines that help people to walk to others that assist with mobility. Experts say this is just the beginning, but the goal of an affordable autonomous healthcare robot is still many years off. By the middle of the century, almost half of Japan's population will be over the age of 65, something that the town of Nomuku is already familiar with. Cafe owner Hiroko Imai, closing up after another quiet day, is worried about what the future will bring.
現状は維持できなくなっているというのは、多分我々だけではなくて政府も国も分かっていることだと思います。ただまだそれは、簡単には解決はできない。
Thank you.